Hello, buddy. Welcome to another episode of Basement Electronics. Today, we're going to take a look at the ESP32 cam. Now, this has been getting a lot of attention lately, but it's really just the same as your standard ESP32 dev board, with a couple little differences. So, this is going to be a quick start guide on getting this working.
When you look at the camera module, one of the first things you'll notice is that there's no USB port on it like you would find on your standard ESP32 dev board. You'll also notice it doesn't have as many pins, as many GPIO pins. But we're not going to worry about that today. But what it does have, it has a camera. This one still has its little protective film on it. It has an LED, and it has an SD card slot on it. And this particular one, the ESP32 module on it is by AI Thinker, which is going to be important when we look at the software later. So without the USB port, we're going to need to use our FTDI cable. Now, I've heard mixed opinions about whether or not a standard TTL UART cable would work on this. Some people say it will, some people say it won't. But because I don't have a working TTL cable, I'm going to use my FTDI. I'm also going to use a breadboard to hook up the wires, just so it's a little easier to see how everything plugs in. There. Now, to make things easier to follow, I kept the wires hooked up to the FTDI the same color as the wires coming out of the cable itself. So, ground is black. This will be 5 volts because it's coming from USB. Our transmit line is going to be green, then our receive line is going to be white. First of all, our receive line is going to have to go to our UART transmit pin, which is labeled UOT on the board. Then likewise, our transmit pin from the FTDI needs to go to the receive pin, or UOR, on the ESP. Now, with the standard ESP32, when you want to flash this, you want to hold down the flash button. And what this is doing, it's grounding out GPIO0 to put the chip into bootloader mode. Well, this doesn't have that flash button. It has a reset button, but no flash. So that's what this wire here is for. We have our GPIO0 pin hooked up to ground, and that will put it into programming mode. Now that we have this wired up, we're going to plug it in to our USB. And then we're going to go to our Arduino IDE. We're going to open the camera example. Now, as usual, make sure that your boards and your libraries are all up to date in Arduino. We're going to be going to ESP32 camera web server, and we're going to use this example as our quick start. Now, the first thing you want to do is remember on the actual chip, it said AI Thinker. So we want to make sure that we uncomment the proper camera model so that it'll properly read in the pins. Next thing we want to do, we want to set up our wireless. Then from there, I recommend just taking a look through, these are all the definitions for the camera and how the ESP32 cam reads that camera. And this is why there aren't as many pins on the board, because most of them are wired internally so that you can use that camera module. Now, this part here, this sets the quality of the video stream
that you collect from your camera. We'll come back to this once we get it running. The rest of the included files here, again, definitely an interesting read to find out how it all works, but we're not going to worry about these in today's video. Now, Camera Index, this is going to be the web interface that we're going to be connecting to through the browser in order to interact with our camera. And this here is our actual web app. And then the next thing we need to do is set up our board information. Now, before we were using the ESP32 dev module, but with this board, we want to use the WRover module. And the reason why we want to do that is because the WRover has some special settings for the PSRAM, which is used for buffering the images from the camera in order to create the video stream. Next thing we need to do is we need to change the partition scheme from default to huge app, 3 meg, no OTA. And what this does is it makes all of the internal memory on the ESP32 available in order to run the application and process the video images coming in from the camera. And of course, select our port. So let's compile and upload this. All right, now that's done, the first thing we want to do is open the serial monitor and then just reset the board. Remove the flash cord, then reset the board. And it'll give you an address and two ports. Now the port 80, that's your web interface. Or if you want the raw video screen stream, you're going to want port 81. So let's bring over our web browser. Copy the URL. And you'll see some settings. Well, first thing, before we start the stream, let's just kind of prop this up. This is going to be a wonderful view, I'm sure. Start. And there's the stream upside down. Just turn this around. So you'll see the logo is now on my left. So flip it over. And there it is, and it's glorious. 320 by 240. Glory. Let's take the little plastic thing off here. Yeah, a little better. Let's bump this up, we'll say 640 by 480. This is going to take a second to process. So that's a little better. It's still a little jumpy though. And then with quality, the lower the number, this is the compression level. So if you bump it right up full, you kind of lose a few pixels. And you can, you know, control your brightness and color. You can apply special effects like negative, various tints. Now it says sepia. I find it's only just a yellow tint. See? Or I guess orange. I'm not particularly impressed by it. White balance. It's a little better, a little warmer. But as you can see, it has all sorts of various settings. So that's all there really is to getting the camera going. Now this is about as far as I really wanted to go today. I just wanted to show the quick setup, how to get the camera going. So I'm going to revisit this, and I'm going to get into the functions that are used to get the video and still stream from the camera.
I'm also going to look at getting the LED here working. This is actually a very bright LED. It's a white LED, really good for providing a camera light. And I'm also going to see about getting this SD card working. Because in the end, what I would like to do is I would like to use this for a project. So I'm going to finish this here. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you found it interesting, if not informative. And I'll see you next time. Goodbye.